So today I'm going to talk to you about about the second order adaptive modeling of the interaction of joint decision making, bonding, and mirroring. Before we start talking about the model, I first want to explain you a little bit about bonding and mirroring. Bonding is the principle where individuals form stronger connections when they have shared experiences, and this is in connection with the homophily principle, where individuals form stronger connections when they are similar to each other in terms of, for example, demographics or interests. This could also be linked to the quote, "Birds of a feather flock together" from Macpherson, Smith, Loving, and Cook. Another principle that we will use is mirroring. And in mirroring, it's a process of where people unconsciously mimic each other's behavior. And this could be linked to Hebbian learning, which is from the principle that neurons that fire together wire together. So there is reinforcement of social bonds when there is a when there is more interaction. In earlier work, we made a conceptual representation of how an agent would come to a decision. We linked those to neural correlates, and we had on the left side the sensory representation states, which represent the way that stimuli are processed in the brain. We have this for actions, emotions, and external stimuli. And on the right side, we have preparation states for those actions and emotions. And we made these this representation into a model. And this is the interaction between two agents. So we have person A and person B. And we can see those sensory representation states and preparation states for actions and emotions in both agents and how they linked to each other. And those are linked between each other with those bonding links we talked about earlier. And within the person, we see Hebbian learning links. And in this work, we took this model and took it into and added two extra levels, a first reification level and a second reification level. And we added those. The first reification level contains W states, which reflect that our links in our base level, which we can see in pink. So that those links are bonding links and Hebbian learning links are not adapting in a static manner, but in a dynamic manner. So their adjustments could increase or decrease over time. And our second reification level describes the speed of which this happens. So here again, we have our agent A and B and their interactions. Here we have a little overview of all the states that are included in the model. So we have per agent five states that represent the sensory representation and the preparation states. And we have per agent two Hebbian learning, well, two states that influence the Hebbian learning. And two that influence how the homophily changes over time. And then per agent, we have in our third level a state that represents the speed of how the Hebbian learning changes and how the homophily connections changes. So we will simulate four different scenarios to test our model. We first have our normal situation that will function as sort of a baseline. Then we have a scenario where we have lower learning. So we put our persistence rate lower, which will represent a reduced ability to learn from previous experiences. We have a third scenario which is lower bonding. So we lower our tipping point. And this means that a higher similarity between agents is required. And lastly, we will combine scenario two and three with lower learning and lower bonding. What we will investigate is whether or not our agents will form a joint decision. And this joint decision will be defined as a joint decision will be made when agents develop similar values for our preparation states. So this could be either negative or positive. So if our preparation states will be both negative, this still means our agents came to a joint decision, as well as if they are forming both high values, it also counts as a joint decision. So for first, we will look at our first scenario, which would be our baseline. Here we can see the development of the preparation states over time. In red and blue, we see the preparation state for the action and emotion of our agent A. And in orange and yellow, we see the development of the preparation state values for the action of B and also emotion of B. And we can see that over time, the values of both agents grow to a higher value, which we could conclude that our agents come to a positive joint decision that is also emotion-based. In our second scenario, I don't know what's happening. Oh, there we go. We put our persistence rate lower for the happy in learning. And we can see here the development in the preparation states again. So we can see that here for agent A, the preparation values for the action as well as for the emotions stay a lot lower than they do for B. So here we can conclude that our agents don't come to a joint decision. And we can compare it with our baseline and we can see the difference between the development for agent A. Then we have our scenario three with the low bonding. If we compare this with the baseline, we can see that there aren't as clear results with the scenario with low learning, but we do see that the decision for agent A comes a little bit later than it would in the baseline example. And our last scenario has low learning and low bonding, and we can see those results are a little similar to our scenario two, where we see that there again is no joint decision between the two agents. We can conclude from these results that happy in learning has a great influence in the making of a joint decision compared to the homophily. Well, the bonding, as we could see that in scenario three, the results are almost similar to our baseline. And we can see that in the combined scenario, there is almost no difference to our scenario two, which had the lower learning. So that was the presentation about the second order adaptive model.